You're at 33350 Schoenher Road, Sterling Heights, Michigan.
Thursday included the Lions, who still hold picks 2 and 32. The end of the first round, usually a good spot for quarterbacks to land in order for teams to hold that fifth-year option, meaning taking one or other teams trading up to get one. A report from Bruce Feldman of The Athletic says that at least one quarterback coach believes that Liberty's Malik Willis left top 8 arm strength in the league when he arrives. Draft analyst Greg Cosell had this to say when he was right here on the ticket last week.
You know, I've seen people compare him to Josh Allen in terms of the fact that Allen came in and people viewed him as extremely raw and inaccurate for the most part, and look at Josh Allen now. So the feeling is Malik Willis has the chance to be special in people's minds because he has the ability to throw the ball really well. He's got great velocity, and he can make second reaction plays.
Betting odds are still on the lines to end up with Michigan's Aiden Hutchinson at number 2 overall. Detroit teams on the field and ice tonight. The Tigers will start a 3-game series in Minnesota. Probably going to be pretty cold out. Eduardo Rodriguez trying to build on a quality start in his last outing. Game time at 7:40 from Target Field right here on 97.1 The Ticket. Over on WWJ, the Red Wings will have their second-to-last game of the season. They face the Maple Leafs on the road at 7 o'clock, looking for their first win against Toronto. At the Ticket Update Desk, I'm Chris Villar. For more, stay tuned to 97.1 The Ticket and Odyssey.com.
Hey, I'm Scott Bentley, host of the Locked On Podcast, the daily podcast covering your favorite team.
All right, thank you. Scotty, you got to put a little energy into it, babe. Got to.
We will be here all season.
Hi, everyone.
Make sure you join us for all 160 games.
I mean, I don't need you to sound like Jimmy Walker.
It could be dynamite.
But I need you to have a pulse. That came across your desk as a teacher, what grade is that given?
That is the... My thing is, I won't fail you. I'm going to play it for everybody so everybody can mock you, and then you go do it again.
Just do it again.
Right.
Here we go again. We can't hear anybody. Nobody can talk to anybody.
Oh, man. I dig that. And for the record, young Mr. Bentley apparently did recut the promo. Now, I haven't heard it. I know they were running Deez's promo for Lockdown Lions, but apparently he did recut it. Little energy almost, goes a long way in this game.
Almost immediately from what I heard, so.
Yes. That was bad. All right, so look, we got some draft stuff to get to. Where, once again, I'll tell you, I think Aiden's a good player. I'm just not sure he's great. You'll get your underwear up to
crack. I can't believe you said you're not fitting him for a gold jacket.
But
he's good.
But he's going to be the number one pick, and he's great, Mike.
Hey, I listen, we'll get to it, because I'm going to give you Aiden Hutchinson at 2. But then you're going to give me what I want. I'll tell you what it is at 3. We'll have a deep dive into this. But we got to start somewhere else, because I want to get it out of the way. This is like taking the trash out. You just get it out of the way. No one enjoys taking the trash out. Rico wants to deliver something. This is him teeing something up, because he knows he's going to get something back. So go ahead.
Here's the beauty of it. Last night, the world celebrated. I felt bad for you because I know you wanted to go to Boston, but
may I say,
the Celtics handled business even though I may have seen the worst 6th foul calls.
Oh, Scott Foster!
Ever!
Scott Foster on Tatum!
I don't care about either team.
Terrible.
I'm like, the guy just fell backwards. And that was a 6th foul, but they had already challenged, so they couldn't challenge a foul.
Terrible.
Tatum's gone. The Nets are trying not to get swept. They get swept. I'm okay with that. Everybody's yucking it up.
And I'll save the trip. I'll go a little later in the playoffs. I'll be fine. We'll go see him play the Bucks.
I heard and saw something I couldn't believe. I can't even put it into words. So we just kind of broke it up into a little bit. But here is what Kyrie Irving had to say after the loss.
Well, yeah, I think it was just really heavy emotionally this season. We all felt it. I felt like I was letting the team down at a point where I wasn't able to play. You know, we were trying to exercise every option for me to play, but I never wanted to just be about me. And I think it became a distraction at times. And, you know, as you see, we just had some drastic changes. You know, we lost a franchise player and we got a franchise player back.
So, I mean, let's deconstruct that statement. And the lie detector test results have shown that was a lie.
You are not the father.
You know, like,
at times, I felt like it was my fault.
Well, because in fact it was.
Because they, you know, we tried to figure out every way to get me to play. Like,
except the one way that you could play.
And then we lost a player, but we got one. Like, you lost
because
a player.
Because that player was so tired of your ish that he wanted out of town.
You made James Harden look like the good guy. Like, I'm trying here. But he won't play. Coach, you got to get me out of here. James Harden, who will frequent any strip club in any town.
At any point?
His work ethic ain't the greatest. But he plays.
All right.
But Kyrie didn't want to be a distraction. But then we got somebody in return. You got a corpse in return.
Okay, we'll get there. We'll get there. Hold on. You got any more before I get into this?
Yeah, just disappointment, sadness, but also more importantly, on the positive side, this is motivation. And, you know, it's just burning in my heart right now. You know, I know so many people wanted to see us fail at this juncture, you know, picked us as contenders and, you know, have so much to say at this point. So I'm just using that as fuel for the summer and coming to the season starting from October. And just getting a good start as a team, and you know, hopefully we don't run into any barriers, and we can just start fresh.
Barriers? You mean like you're not doing what the rest of your team did, even though you paid $40 million to do it? Is that a barrier we're talking about?
The people who were hating on him, Kyrie, you were the preseason favorite to win it all.
Everybody picked you. Nobody was picking against you.
Can I do the other thing real quick, please?
No, this is...
I just thought it was hilarious.
The everybody...
I understand now why you call him penis cancer.
Yes.
He's the highest form of sports cancer that exists. He's a horrendous human. I would never... There's not a scenario. I don't care if I am the most broke bleep team in the league. I wouldn't give this guy a long-term contract. Ever. Ever. Ever.
Well, now the Nets are stuck because he can walk.
Well, look at his play. Yeah, good. No more!
No more!
Look, here's what kills me with these guys. And a lot of these athletes, they are really just idiot millennials with a lot of money. Kyrie Irving, well, everybody wanted us to fail. Kyrie, you make $40 million a year. You think the guy who works at the oil change likes the way you behave? Or is thrilled for you? Like you're in a position of privilege. People want you to fail. Go cry to your therapist. Oh, nobody was on our side. That's kind of how it works when you make yourself a villain and you play for a major market team. The only people that want you to succeed are hipsters in Brooklyn wearing their Basquiat jersey. Nobody cares. Why do athletes do this? If you don't want people to root against you, then just go back to being anonymous. Nobody will care about you. The world only cares about people and roots against them if they are rich and or famous. Usually both. Like, people wanting you to fail is the ultimate compliment because it means you've actually attained a position that people are desired. Like, that people want this. I just, everything he says... Everything. Now, see, I didn't hear the middle part. The part I did read in an article out of New York papers is him wanting a co-management role.
Oh, there was more. But
do we have that bread where he talks about I'm here with Kev and in a co-management role along with